Hey there. So I am currently just editing the video that you're about to watch, and I found out that the mic that I was using was not plugged in. But as a commitment to myself, I am still going to upload it, and maybe you can just follow along and not listen to any of the coaching, put your own music on, and still get a good workout in. But I will refilm something else and put it up. But this is Ziggy saying to future Ziggy, you did it. You uploaded it and you worked out and you showed up.
Hey there, welcome. Today, my name is Ziggy Sekwama, and I am currently postpartum with my third child. Today, I wanted to get a little bit sweaty, but also do some really good intentional movement for my postpartum period. We are going to be doing a little interval workout and taking it easy and then increasing intensity or increasing difficulty of the movement. Each round, we're going to be working for 60 seconds, and all you'll need today is a mat or space to work out and a chair or a ball. All right, let's get started. Okay, so movement number one today is inchworms. We're going to start out with feet hip distance apart. We're going to hinge backwards from our hips, and then we're going to walk it out. Let's go. So we're just going to walk it out. We're doing 60 seconds of these. We're going to hold in a high plank position. And then just move it. For round two and round three, we're going to make it a little bit more difficult. So when we walk it out, I want to see you drawing your belly in towards the spine, hugging the ribs and hips towards each other, and then pressing up through the shoulder joint. And then walking it back. If you have tight hamstrings, feel free to bend the knees slightly as you walk it out. If it feels really difficult, you can just come all the way down onto all fours and then press it back. Down in that all fours position, I want you to be thinking about strong through the midline, drive the belly so you're not chilling at the bottom. Okay? So we've got about 10 more seconds. Let's see if we can get one more. Remember, this is round one. We're just taking it easy, using this as hip mobility and rest. Okay. We're going to rest for 30 seconds. Movement number two is a sit back. Rotation. So the point of the sit back is basically to be able to strengthen that movement so that we can move forwards into being able to do the sit up. So what we're going to do, feet firmly planted, we're going to tuck from the pelvis and draw the belly button in and draw the pelvic floor up. We do that with our exhale. So take a nice big inhale, off we go. Exhale, tuck it round, and then we're going to sit back up. So I like to try and do it with one full exhalation. Inhale. Exhale, tuck. Inhale. Exhale, lift your pelvic floor, belly round. Sorry, not belly round. Your spine is going to round, your belly is going to concave in. Inhale. Exhale, lift your pelvic floor. So I'm basically going to the point. You might be able to go further, you might be able to come as far as me. I'm going to the point where I feel like I can't go back anymore without my belly going. Exhale. Got 10 more seconds. Last one. Good. And rest. All right, 30 seconds. We're going to be doing reverse lunges. So when we first lunge, what I want you to think about is that your legs are in a set of train tracks. Your left leg is only going to stay within the left train track and the right only within the right. And then when I come back to the center, I still have space between the legs. I don't put my legs together. If you find this really challenging, you can have a wall, a finger on a wall to help you for balance, or if you need more support, you can use the wall to help you push back up. All right, off we go. So we're going to make this harder next few rounds, but what we're gonna do is I'm also so used to coaching that I project my voice because I'm used to coaching people in a big group setting, and I always forget that I have a mic and then I get very enthusiastic, so I really apologize for the audio. So if you feel like going at this pace is a little bit too much for you in your early postpartum period, just keep that hands on hips, knee comes back, you're trying to draw the knee towards the floor, back up with intention, and then feet at the top. Back. And then when you're here, I want you to think about your ribcage. So ribcage down, hips towards the ribs. that when we're coming down, what we don't want to see is a big flare through the ribcage and arch the back, just so you can get that hand. All right, 10 more seconds.
Or when we lunge, we're going to come up, we're going to
So let's regain some of that proprioception. All right, off we go. So I'm taking my right foot back. And so my left leg is going to be my stabilizing leg. I'm going to hold and then swap leg. So right foot goes down and then hold and then swap. But you know, if you do this and you're getting confused with like left and right, don't stress. Just keep moving. Do some work. And then feel free to take it at whatever pace you need to. Again, chair, balance. 30 seconds left. Balance, stability. I always think the gym is a metaphor for life as well. So when I do any balance run, I'm like, I think my mind more balanced, my mind more stable, not just my body. Good. So remember, keeping that you're looking towards each other. We got 10 seconds left. So you can get at least two more reps in. Last five. Three, two, one. Really good job. All right. We're going for our glute bridges. This time, keeping the foot. What we're going to do is we're going to elevate the heels. Okay. So you can either elevate them onto a chair or against the wall. And this just basically gets more glute. Or feel free to stay at the level one if you need to. Whatever you need for today. What's more important is the integrity of good movement, not pushing to a movement that's too challenging. Off we go. Let's exhale. Just 60 seconds of work. So now that my surface is, my feet are elevated, I'm getting more hamstring. But what's more important to me is that there's no pain in the lower back, okay? I'm not lifting from my lower back. So what that looks like is I'm just slamming the butt into the floor like this, and then my belly is protruding. So we think about rib cage down. Belly towards the top, squeezing the bum at the top, and then same thing. I'm trying to bring my middle back, lower back, then my bum down to the floor. Got 20 seconds left. I'm trying to shout into the side. I'm sorry, I'm going to try to hold my body down. Alright, 10 seconds left. Squeeze the bum, feel the hamstrings, back of the leg should be. Three, two, one, rest. Good. And then if you're doing this and you're like, oh, this is way too difficult, when am I ever going to feel like myself again? A month ago, I couldn't do any of this stuff. I was 5 kilos heavier. I still have about 10 kilos left in my mouth. And I'm going to try to make 3 pregnancy weight. But it'll happen. Just keep showing up. Alright. 10 more seconds. We're going to go back to our inch marks. With our push-up, this time we're going to jump at the top of the back up. Off we go. So we're going to walk it out. I'm going to go for my version of my good push-up. Exhale. When I push back this time, I'm just going to do a little hop. And so if you want to be here to do an impact in, or you find that you peak when you jump, what I want you to do instead is think about lifting and doing a calf raise and lifting the pelvic floor. So, I highly recommend going to sleep on the focus of nervous if you have anything here. And especially if you're experiencing symptoms like leaking, coughing, jumping, leaking wind, we call those things, sorry. Because it might not be a weakness issue, it might be a tightness issue last 10 seconds. Let's get one more rep. Rotate, rotate, and then back up. we're done. Sorry, I'm almost done. Just two more. Okay, 10 more seconds, and then we're going to do our reverse lunges. This time at the top, we're going to do a hop. So when you reverse lunge, you're going to come back up, and instead of just balancing, you can either come up onto a tippy toe or you can hop. Ready? Off we go. So right leg goes back. Once I stabilize, I hop, and then I swap legs. So my left leg goes back. Exhale, lift and jump. Right? And then again, so if you don't have the capacity to jump yet, what you're going to do is you're going to practice balancing. So then you're here, you tippy toe, and then you come back down, and then you swap. And just whatever you have on. Alright, that's 30 seconds, and let's do another 30 seconds. So this is the one that brings the cardio in, especially if you're thinking about returning to running. This is what you want to practice. Single leg stability, the ability to bound, the ability to catch yourself. It's when you start going running again. You're going to be on the balls of your feet. The first run you might do, you might feel like wobbly all over the place if your ankles don't have you. Last 10 seconds, and up. And 3, 2, 1, and then rest. Good job. Okay. Final one, our glute bridges. So 30 seconds rest. This time, when we do our glute bridges, we're going to have our arms in front of us. And then we're going to take them back. So both legs onto your chair, your wall, your sofa, whatever you're using. So my arms are going to be here. I'm going to drag my hips up without anything changing. Arms come back, exhale, and then come down. Okay, let's try it. Off we go. So 60 seconds of work. Lift through the hips, exhale. Arms are moving up. I'm not opening through your hinge. And then come down. So when you bring your arms back forward, exhale, come up. So when I bring my arms back here, I'm pushing my hips up towards the ceiling of the floor, lifting through the pelvic floor of the floor. So it's very subtle. It's an internal feeling. But when you're doing it, good, turn, back up. I want you to really be thinking about the muscles, not just the movement and what it looks like, but what it feels like inside. So exhale, lift the hips, squeeze the butt, lift the pelvic floor, arms are back, your patient's move, arms forward. Okay, last 10 seconds, exhale. Sorry, there's some very cute kids who want to play on this ground, so there will be no outro. Just know that you did a really good job. Final breath, last 3 seconds. And up, arms come back, arms go forward, and then down. Okay, well done, team. You did a 20-minute workout. Proud of you, proud of myself. Okay, well done, goodbye.